told you to text me before it gets too bad. I know. You never want to help in the moment, but do me a favor and get used to it. Please. Pretty, pretty, please. Because I care about you. Can I see? Fresh. The other one. So what happened? Do you want to talk about it? A flashback. I'll listen if you want me to. From the pharmacy on the way. Yeah, I know my backpack is falling apart. That's not the point. It's okay. We've got to disinfect this. This is gonna help it heal twice as fast. Some of this. Hold on a second. Much prefer it over those icky fructose candies. Ugh. Cannot stand them. Right? At least give me real candy. Not hard at all. I picked this up because it said spray on Band-Aid, and it said it kills bacteria instantly. I've never used this before, but I thought it couldn't hurt, unless it does, in which case, sorry, but can't get out of this one. Okay, I hope now. How long is this gonna dry for? A minute. Alright, I think we can manage that. It's gonna dry off my hand again. Yeah, maybe a clean tissue is a good idea. Like this for a minute. I'm gonna do the other arm now. Can I have this one? Sorry, I have to go through this. It's not your fault. Not used to hearing that, huh? Regarding something that you obviously do to yourself, but you didn't exactly go and pick it up as a hobby, did you? See? Exactly. So it's not your fault. Yeah. don't know what it's like when no one gives a fuck, unless you're obviously sick. I like the sound. I would let you play with these, but given the situation, it's really stretchy. For all intents and purposes, give me that. That's it. just what we need right now. You're right. Is there anything you need? Do you want me to open the window? Let's give that a try. Some fresh air will do you good. Something slightly more calming. I'll leave it here with you just in case. I'll dispose of this when I get home. This the one, is it? Yeah, I'm taking that too. As well as. I'm sure you have more, and I'm sure you're not inclined to tell me where you're stashing them, but just, you know, as a gesture of my loving care for you. You're thirsty. Stay hydrated. Is this your glass? Be good for you. Just a little bit at a time, that's okay. It's just that vibration of water will help soothe your nerves and your system. Also, useful. Don't mind my knee. It does hurt. Think you can use a little taste of your own medicine. If I can get this to burn enough. Smudge a little bit, which should help soothe you. Just a little bit of this goes a long way. This burned down. I don't suppose you've talked to anyone about it yet. Yeah, well, you're all patched up now, so it should heal quite nicely. gotta put on some long sleeves for a little while. I know it's hard to put your trust in people. It feels like no one gives a damn, and some of them might even want to see you suffer. But you didn't deserve that. Life can be hard to handle sometimes. Unbearable at times. I'm here for you now. I'm sorry I couldn't be when all this happened in the first place. I'm sorry, I don't have the power to talk some sense into idiots. They most likely wouldn't understand anyway. That's how it always goes, doesn't it? I know. That seems to be the consensus. You're young and you're smart, therefore you're not allowed to have any problems. And if you do, or if you talk about it, then you're just doing it for attention. Every single time without fail. And then when you finally crack, when it's finally too much, when you can't take it anymore, They blame it all on you. Make it sound like there's something wrong with you. It never does make them reflect on their own words or their own actions. No, it's always like, you're crazy and you're insane, so you need to be fixed. And people just refuse to take responsibility for the pain they inflict on other people. They flat out deny it. And I hate them for that. I hate them for hurting you. You didn't deserve that. I wish I could just snap my finger and take all your pain away so that you don't have to do this to yourself. But I know it's not quite that easy, is it? I just want you to know I understand where you're coming from. I know what it's like when they finally see that you're not okay and they start avoiding you as though you're contagious. And it just makes you feel more alone when what you need more than anything in the world is just for somebody to be with you. And just see how much you're hurting. I know you don't tell me everything. I can see in your eyes how deep your pain goes. And I can see the part of you that is just screaming and screaming. They convinced you that you're not worth it. And I know every time somebody has tried to help you in the past, it's always been kind of like, I need to fix you so that I can go on my merry way again and leave you again. I don't know, that's why why part of you doesn't want to stop. Because it feels like no one would want to be with you for you. And that being in pain, visibly in pain, is the only way you can get somebody to care about you. So of course when you're not in pain, you feel more alone than ever. But I can see the part of you that wants to open up to me. And I'm thankful for that. I can see the part of you that's skeptical. And reasonably so. Me to go. Want to be held? I'm here for you. I'm not going anywhere. Do you want me to hang out a little? We can just listen to music or something if you want. Or watch some funny videos. If you need a distraction. anything you want. And I tried a new coffee flavor. It's important to try new things occasionally. Today I had iced white coffee, no, white chocolate cappuccino. And I watched the barista make it, and it was just a cappuccino blended with ice and this white chocolate, you know, flavoring that they put in drinks sometimes. Yeah, you can put it in cocktails or coffee drinks. I have some of those at home. I have a creme brulee flavor and I have hazelnut flavor, and then I what was the other one? Oh, chocolate chip cookie. Three flavors. That was pretty good, but not caffeinated enough for me. Maybe next time I'll ask for a double iced cappuccino. And then this lady in those blue pants, and I'm talking like turquoise, was hawking the good massage chair, so I just waited until she got up, and then I got in the massage chair and started the massage and realized maybe it's not such a good idea because yesterday I bruised my back trying to record it. Bruises from pressure. It's not super bad though. Just don't have quite enough foresight to realize that maybe I shouldn't get a back rub when my back is all sore and bruised. I tried my best, but it was not meant. A beautiful evening. It was kind of sunny, which I had kind of expected. I mean, they promised sunshine, but the weather report is always kind of fucked. So it never matches reality. So crowds. knows what you're going through now. I've been there myself. And some things just never seem to stop. But no matter what happens, you've got someone who understands. Thank you.